Masahiro Tanaka taking his warm-up tosses before his first outing of the spring. Looks like he's ready to go. The ball's going to be thrown down to second base. Tanaka, of course, last year, great numbers, 13-5, 2.77. And as we told you, strike out to walk ratio was outstanding. He was an all-star last year. Let's check out the pitcher scouting portal. Masahiro had 8 strikeouts, so a hit and some misses in that game as well.
His first pitch of 2015 is a strike as he gets ahead of Andrelton Simmons.
And I should say about that game on the 14th of May last year against the Mets, that was his first major league shutout as well.
Tanaka was the goods when on the mound last season. A sub-3 ERA, the 13-5 record, and strike two to Simmons.
That was the slider. Of course, when the hitters got to 2 strikes, that feared splitter was always on the horizon, and every hitter had it in their mind. And Andrelton Simmons, although he didn't face Tanaka last year, I think word has spread throughout baseball.
The 0-2, chopped to short. Gregorius fields a nice hop and one away easily for Tanaka as we take a look at the defense presented by your Mercedes-Benz Tri-State. For the game, Tanaka slated for 30 to 35 pitches tonight. First ball of the evening for Tanaka. Freddie Freeman stepping in, the 2-time All-Star. Off to a sparkling start in camp with 2 home runs, 5 extra base hits, and a breaking ball strike from Tanaka.
76 miles an hour, so changing speeds here in the first inning. Looks pretty good. What, he's thrown one ball this inning?
One ball. The 1-1 from Tanaka. Swing and a miss. Good movement.
Here's that splitter.
Tanaka did make those 2 starts at the end of the regular season after missing a couple of months with the partial tear of his elbow ligament. Deals high, and Joe Girardi thought that probably takes away some of the angst of this start. Had he not gotten in at all last year, he would have been a little bit more concerned, curious. The 2-2. Foul tipped.
And maybe he can get out of this inning with less than a dozen pitches.
The 2-2. He got it. A smooth 11-pitch first inning for Masahiro Tanaka, looking sharp in his 2015 debut. All-star Freddie Freeman. Here he faces Johnny Gomes. Strike one.
Johnny Gomes signed by the Braves as a free agent. Spent last year with the part of last year with the Boston Red Sox and a shorter time with the Oakland A's last season. Veteran outfielder, played for the Rays at one time
for quite a while. Mm-hmm. As Tanaka skips that one by McCann. Gomes spending his first 6 seasons with Tampa. You see the numbers between Boston and Oakland last year. The 1-1 from Tanaka.
You know, it's you saw it
through 4 batters. The 1-2, swing and a miss. Strikeout number 2 for Masahiro Tanaka.
Well, Tanaka, as we mentioned last year, he had 5 games in which he struck out 10. He's not going to get the chance to do that tonight, but there's a splitter. And that was a pretty good one. Not the best that he can throw.
Facing Chris Johnson. Bethencourt. And Bethencourt takes just a little bit. Absolutely not. Looks exactly as good. As that's grounded to short. Gregorius stays down. 2 more quick outs for Tanaka. Here is Chris Johnson, the third baseman. Tanaka gets ahead again, working all of his pitches too, Kent. Now 30 to 35 is the pitch number that Joe Girardi's aiming for. That was thought to be 2 innings, but at this rate it might be 4.
Well, I don't think they're going to let him go 4 anyway. They might let him go throw some ball pitches in the bullpen.
That's a fair ball. The long throw in time from Headley. And Masahiro Tanaka cruises through another 1-2-3 inning. may very well see another.
DH against a real tough customer for New York.
Masahiro Tanaka got shut down late last year because of some elbow issues, but look what he had done prior to that. And he was the American League Pitcher of the Month in May. He was 5-1 in May with a 1.88 ERA. Has a devastating split finger pitch to go with a good slider.
He pitched great against the Braves in his last outing. And he misses to former Yankee, Yuri Perez.
Braves got him off waivers from the Yankees. I mean, the lineup today, tonight, six guys in the lineup that have never had on a Braves uniform prior to this spring training. Now, Kelly Johnson has come back to the team. He was an original Braves signee.
One Rule 5 pick for the Braves this offseason. Off the knuckles out towards second, and Stephen Drew makes the play. And former Brave Jeff Francoeur gave you a scouting report on Peterson, didn't he?
He did. Shortly after the trade was made, I got a hold of Jeff, and he said, this guy just needs an opportunity. He loves to play, plays hard, and can do a lot of things to help you win. But the best report I got from anybody was from Carlos Tosca, the bench coach for the Braves today. And I said, tell me about Jace Peterson. And he said, he's a baseball player. And that's about the greatest compliment you can give anyone, because it means so much.
Pretty good pitch.
Real good.
Called a ball, even count.
Tough to lay off that one.
Yankee fans chirping at Joe West here in the first.
Well, that evens it up a little bit.
That one at the belt and a called third strike. Two out.
But keeping a close eye on him.
Freddie Freeman's had a terrific spring. Couple of homers. And a rocket down the right field line. And one catch. Good pitch. In fact, the Yankees and Tanaka, they've toyed with the idea of time to time going with a six-man rotation. Try to give him an extra day of rest in between starts, which was customary in Japan. They pitched with five full days of rest. He's not used to pitching every fifth day here in the States.
What was it his pitching coach said today, Larry Rothschild, that last year Tanaka told him, boy, that fifth day comes around fast. And he wasn't used to it.
One ball, two strikes. Base is clear for Freddie. And now 2-2. They also got good news to the Yankees. CeCe Sabathia pitched the other day.
Well, I was going to say that it's kind of a twofold there in terms of their six-man rotation thoughts, because to try to protect CeCe Sabathia and his bad knee, too.
CeCe threw a couple of innings for New York. Gave up a couple of runs, but touched 90. Shift on for Freeman with two outs. Back out of play to stay even. That's over the Yankee dugout. Another 2-2 for Freddie. Full count. Johnny Gomes waits on deck. Braves cleanup man. Eighth pitch of the at-bat for Freeman. And got him with it. Good pitch. Three up, three down for Tanaka in a scoreless first. Braves skipper Freddie Gonzalez will join us when we head to the second inning in Orlando.
He's one of them. Been in the postseason last several years. Veteran-type guy that loves to play. Aggressive, hyper.
when Johnny said, look, I can't imagine walking up to Bobby Cox, the Hall of Fame Braves manager who's around camp, and say, hey, Skipper, we're going to try to get to 500 this year.
Yeah. Well, the players don't like any thoughts or insinuation that they're not going to compete for the National League East title. Because I think this is a ball club better suited for today's game.
There's a shot the other way. Nice play by Garrett Jones at first, and he'll win the race to the bat position, and that is something he talks about and has talked about from the moment he put on a Braves uniform. A.J. Pruszynski lives in Orlando in the offseason. One of the features that attracted him to the herd.
His average was pretty good. A veteran on their ball club. They were trying to try out some younger players.
There's that shot up the middle you were talking about a moment ago. And Pruszynski has...
Kinski. Those guys all had a presence in the clubhouse. They were, even when they weren't playing on the bench, there was a presence from those guys. From a leadership standpoint. And when all of those guys were gone, not all at once, but almost at once, it left a void, and it was kind of incumbent upon Freddie Freeman or Jason Hayward to kind of take that over, and it was slow to come around.
And you are a big believer in that, right? That,
I am.
That veteran presence, clubhouse leadership, as it were?
I am. And certainly with the likes of Gomes, A.J. Pruszynski, and others on the club right now, you're not going to be missing that anymore.
And another year older and wiser for guys like Craig Kimbrell and Freddie Freeman now, and perhaps even Andrelton Simmons.
Yeah.
Has had a great spring. Didi Gregorius, nice play and a swift double play to get his former Little League teammate Andrelton Simmons and in the Atlanta second. Didi Gregorius, the Yankee shortstop, has made a terrific play already tonight. Welcome to the Braves.
Thank you. Thank you.
As Alberto Callespo, I practiced all day, I promise, Mike.
It happens.
How many times, you know. Well, welcome.
Yeah, what, good outing, too.
Yeah, thank you.
A couple of broken bad hits kind of plagued you there late. Yeah, cost you a run, but threw the ball well, I thought.
Yeah, I mean, overall, I threw the ball well. Like you said, a couple broken bats. I'm talking with fastball and off speed, so it was overall pretty good.
Yeah, I thought you had everything working. Did the... Oops.
Tanaka got a piece of that, and Didi Gregorius will clean it up.
Did the trade come as a bit
Astros complex to hear? Can't get lost.
Yeah, no, I know the area pretty well, so that was funny.
Zolio Almonte is going to sky one toward left, and that'll be easy for Perella. It is, two out.
I'm not going to pretend to know the depth of the rotation.
Like you said, there's a couple spots in the rotation at the back end, and you know, I'm going to try my best to, you know, to fight it out, but whatever happens, happens.
To the nth degree.
And if memory serves, that was also a very young ball club with a terrific, potentially good pitching staff. And the Braves added a veteran presence. Sid Breen, Rafael Belliard, Terry Pendleton, Alejandro Pena, Juan Berenguer, for example. All of those guys, and there were others, don't misunderstand. Greg Olson came along.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it was a young ball club.
Similar parallels, you think?
Yes. Time of service for those guys. I mean, most of them were, they probably averaged less than 5 years. There were a couple in 91. That was significant.
Perez, a dribbler toward.
I think there are a lot of qualities about this club that parallel what happened in 91.
There's that split. Tanaka's got a filthy one. Joe talked about that earlier, and that's his third strikeout. He's pitching beautifully. He's faced the minimum so far through three and a third innings.
One of the things about his split pitch, as he demonstrated there, that was going to be a called strike.
Here's Jace Peterson. And there's a called strike. I would assume, Joe, at this level, if you're a professional player, you know how to play. You know how to play the game, or you're supposed to, but knowing how to win is a subtle difference, or maybe a not-so-subtle difference. As that one's rolled over toward Drew at second for out number two, and that's why those...
A lot of difference, and it's a longer season. So you can't feel sorry for yourself at this level because of the grind.
One ball, no strikes for Freddie Freeman. He struck out in the Braves' first.
I asked John Scherholz about the 91 team and what people were saying about it prior to the start of the season, and he told me no one but no one thought they could do what they did.
There's a shot down the right field line and into the corner for Freeman. The ball gets away in the corner for Chris Young. And Freddie will stand at second with a clean double with two outs. That's the second. Tanaka, the Yankee fans give him another big ovation. He looked awfully sharp, and that's the big story of the night for New York, which leads 3-0.
The Yankees 2.77 ERA. These are his numbers this spring, and you can see he's done very well through his first two starts. 5 2/3, 5 strikeouts, hasn't walked anybody, only 2 hits. Opponents batting just 111. Let's check out the pitcher scouting report on Masahiro Tanaka.
Ready. And let's do it here in Tampa, Florida. The first pitch is a strike, and we
are training season going.
Another strike. Home plate umpire is Eric Vines. This is the third base ump. Tanaka deals. That one is hammered to left field, and that ball is off the wall. Played out there by Garrett Jones. Lagares is on second with a Ruben Tejada. And that one is looped into right, caught by Beltran. Holding at second is the last year for the Mets. He's got a big deficiency in his game, though. He doesn't hit lefties that well. Blocked there by Murphy. Not much wind here at Steinbrenner Field today, so.
See that in July.
Another splitter in the dirt. Moving to third is Lagares. The throw goes into left field. Lagares gets up, and he will score. So it'll be a wild pitch and an E2, and the Mets are on the board. They lead 1-0
lead.
Now, we told you this is the first time that Murphy's ever caught 95, as he did at times last year. It's been right around 88 to 91, and he said there's nothing wrong with his elbow.
He's going to make the team. It's not like he's trying to really overly impress anybody. Just getting his work in.
Righty bat off the bench. Some power. And Mayberry goes down on strikes for the second out.
Yeah, first strikeout for Tanaka this afternoon. Let's see how he does it here. And looks to be a slider. Not maybe his best.
Runner at first, two outs. Mets with a run in. Just underway. Strike three. Nieuwenhuis down looking. Mets get a run on one hit. One error. Throwing error by Murphy. It's Mets one. Yankees coming to bat. Travis d'Arnaud will lead off against Tanaka. The first pitch is wrapped into left field. A base hit. Garrett Jones cuts over. D'Arnaud makes a big turn. Throw cut off by Gregorius. There's Johnny Manel. Swings over.
Right down the road from Petticoat Junction.
Grounded to first. Teixeira goes to second, one on to first. It's a double play. 3-6-3. Nice turn there by Gregorius. Chop foul. Swing and a miss.
He's in major leagues with Melky Cabrera. Melky hit a home run off.
Yep.
And then from that point on, just said, okay, I can get serious now.
swing and a miss in the dirt. And Murphy tags out Castellanos. And the Mets do not score here in the second. We'll go to the bottom of the second.
Tommy John surgery. He was slated to go in right behind Matt Harvey in the rotation. But now the Mets have had to scramble.
Work gave up a run in the first. A wild pitch and a throwing error by John Ryan Murphy. Popped up. Right field. And Beltran puts it away. Here's Juan Lagares. Doubled off the wall in the first inning. Eventually came around to score. Really is it. High fly ball, center field. Drifting back is Brett Gardner for the second out.
Yeah, the Mets.
Terry Collins says it's between Lagares and Curtis Granderson, who did not make the trip.
I thought Curtis's leadoff days kind of Yankees, that his leadoff days were over.
But in the National League, a lot of his home runs won't have anybody on base because the pitcher will be hitting in front of him.
Yeah.
And the pitch. Fly ball, right center, drifting over is Gardner in a 1-2-3 inning for Tanaka and the Yankees. Let's go to the bottom of the third. It's 1-0 Mets.
Looks as though the way things are lining up, he may be that opening day starter. Can you tell us out that way? He would be able to have an extra day rest a couple times to start the season. How beneficial would that be for him?
That's part of, I know, Larry's thought process.
It seems like that would be a big mental hurdle, but it doesn't seem like that's been the case for him.
He feels good. He feels healthy. I mean, the tear he has is very, very, very small. And so I think that's probably strikes. He's got an assortment of pitches. He's been a starter, really, his whole career, and we had to collapse him in the pen, and that really feels comfortable. And he's right now the leading guy.
When you're looking at this thing last year, he was so good out of the bullpen. Is it tough to look at that and say he'd be a big asset in the bullpen? As you mentioned Miller, two guys that are going back-to-back for the first time this spring. But do you think there will be a definitive closer when you start the season, or do you think it's going to be depending on the situation and the matchup? About Lindgren, he seems like a guy that's been flying through the system a little bit, obviously. A recent draft pick, went to college, has that experience at least. What has
He seems like he's been around for a long time already. And, he's certainly got, major league stuff that cuts both ways. And so it's tough on a hitter when the ball's moving, east-west as much as it seems to do. So he's going to definitely be somebody. If he doesn't make it in the forefront, he'll make it at some point this year, I'm sure. But we're excited to have him.
For the most part, the team has been pretty healthy so far this spring. Jacoby Ellsbury a little bit banged up. Any concern at all that he's not going to be there for the opening day roster?
No
into this spring and coming into this season, a big one was Alex Rodriguez. Have you been pleasantly surprised with what you've seen from him at the plate?
Yeah, I mean, I think he was feeling his way through position for us, at least, from what we're seeing right now this spring. So, hopefully that can continue and he can impact us in a positive way. You're a pitcher, you can't be comfortable throwing to someone that size. I mean, he is an imposing figure, he's always got that threat to drive the ball. But the fact that he's showing me, obviously, the ability to consistently.
This game, 2-1. Tanaka has 5 strikeouts so far in the game in 3 2/3 innings.
That was an encompassing interview. 9 or 10 more days to get those questions answered. Who's going to shake out and make the team? A lot of young players that have, from the seventh inning on, when the younger players or the players are going to be sent back to the minors, are in the ballgame.
That one's popped up to Teixeira. Gives it a look. And Tanaka deals the 1-2.
Yeah, the third home run of the spring. He's trying to make the team.
The 2-2. In on the hands.
That would have made.
Swing and a miss, so all 3 outs registered, all strikeouts. But the blemish in the inning off the bat of John Mayberry. As he could throw, and is that something that he's just holding back?
Or? He's thrown a lot more sinkers today. That's been a pitch that he has been working on, so you're seeing a lot more of those.
Still seems when he gets 2 strikes, Joe, he's able to put people away.
Yeah, you were saying earlier he had 6 strikeouts in 4 innings. There's a sinker inside.
His bag of tricks here.
He's had it, but he's never used it as much, and it's something that he's really working on.
Got a 1-2 count right here on Monell. And he rocks back and delivers.
That the other person has a chance to work in the bullpen, and we can try to get him back-to-back outings.
Ooh, that was close.
You know, in a sense, the last two spots in the bullpen, those could go down to the wire, and we'll just continue to evaluate.
That one's chopped to first. Teixeira flips to Tanaka. One away. Now, one of the decisions involves...
But you're right. He's done everything right so far in spring training, and we've really loved what we've seen.
Castellanos takes...
Ramped up his conditioning, in a sense, to where we don't know if he'll have the concussion systems come back, but... And when I see him and I look at him and I look him in the eyes, he doesn't really look to have any concussion system symptoms right now.
Strikeout number 7 for Tanaka. Tanaka at 56 pitches. How much do you want to push him today, Joe?
Four more.
So if it's 3-1 count, he's coming out?
He's coming out. He's running slowly over spring training, and that's what we told him to do. You know, I told him, you know, at some point we have to start to see a little more, and he's definitely shown us that. He's running better. Probably what I'm going to do, because Mac's the only one that's really ever caught him.
High fly ball, deep left center field. Jones going back, still back, and that ball is
bounced
a double.
Out.
Ground rule double. You let him throw the one more pitch, Joe?
No, he's out. Larry's going out to get him, so.
All right, so Larry Rothschild does come out, and the 59 pitches for Tanaka. He leaves the game trailing 2-1. And, Joe, we thank you, as always, for joining us.
Thanks, guys.
All right, so they'll make the move to the bullpen. Mets 2, Yankees 1 here in the fifth.